கர்த்தருக்கு புது பாட்டை பாடுங்கள். பூமியின் குடிகளே எல்லாரும் கர்த்தரை பாடுங்கள். கர்த்தரை பாடி அவருடைய நாமத்தை ஸ்தோத்தரித்து நாளுக்கு நாள் அவருடைய ரட்சிப்பை சுவிசேஷமாய் அறிவியுங்கள். ஜாதிகளுக்குள் அவருடைய மகிமையும் சகல ஜனங்களுக்குள்ளும் அவருடைய அதிசயங்களையும் விபரித்து சொல்லுங்கள். கர்த்தர் பெரியவரும் மிகவும் ஸ்தோத்தரிக்கப்படத்தக்கவருமாயிருக்கிறார். எல்லா தேவர்களிலும் பயப்படத்தக்கவர் அவரே. கர்த்தர் பெரியவரும் கிரேட்டஸ்ட் லார்ட் மிகவும் ஸ்தோத்தரிக்கப்படத்தக்கவருமாயிருக்கிறார். கிரேட்லி டு பி பிரேஸ்ட். எல்லா தேவர்களிலும் பயப்படத்தக்கவர் அவரே. He is a God who is greatly to be feared. So let us pray and begin this evening service. Lord, we pray for your divine presence. உம்முடைய தெய்வீக பிரசனம் எங்கள் மத்தியிலே இருந்து எங்களை ஆவியோடும் உண்மையோடும் உம்மை தொழுது கொள்ளவும் உம்முடைய பிரசனத்தை அனுபவிக்கவும் உம்முடைய சுகத்தை இந்த நாளிலே நாங்கள் மனதிலும் சரீரத்திலும் ஆத்மத்திலும் ஆண்டவரே எங்களுடைய எல்லா விதமான காரியங்களிலும் அனுபவிக்கத்தக்கதாக நீர் கிருபையை தாரும். நீர் பெரியவர், நீர் பரிசுத்தர் ஆண்டவரே. கர்த்த ராஜரிகம் பண்ணுகிறீர் ஆண்டவரே. வானங்கள் மகிழ்ந்து பூமி எல்லாம் உடையது. ஜனங்களின் வம்சங்களே கர்த்தருக்கு மகிமையும் வல்லமையும் செலுத்துங்கள். கர்த்தருக்கே அதை செலுத்துங்கள். கர்த்தருக்கு அவருடைய நாமத்திற்குரிய மகிமையை செலுத்தி காணிக்கைகளை கொண்டு வந்து அவருடைய பிரகாரங்களில் பிரவேசியுங்கள். ஆண்டவரே நீர் எங்களுக்கு கிருபை தர வேண்டும் என்று இயேசுவின் நாமத்தினாலே ஜெபிக்கிறோம். ஆமே. ஆரம்ப பாடலை பாடுவோம்.
Oh,
ஜபமும் ஆராதனையும். Everything that we do is worship unto our God. Especially in this context, in this situation that we are all in this pandemic that is beginning to hit globally in such a different way, more than what happened a year ago. We as followers of Christ are asked to give to our God a sacrifice of praise.
எபிரேயர் 13 அதிகாரம் 15 வசனத்தை சொல்லி இருக்குது, ஆகையால் அவருடைய நாமத்தை துதிக்கும் உதடுகளின் கனியாகிய ஸ்தோத்திர பலியை அவர் மூலமாய் எப்போதும் தேவனுக்கு செலுத்த கடவோம்.
Through Jesus, therefore, let us continually offer to God a sacrifice of praise, the fruit of lips that confess his name. When we say sacrifice, there is bloodshed. Something has to be paid. And Jesus paid that ultimate sacrifice for us. And David says in Psalm 51, the sacrifices of God are a broken spirit. A broken and a contrite spirit, O God, you will not despise.
ஒரு உடைந்த இருதயம், உடைந்து போன தோய்வுற்ற ஒரு ஆவி, அதுவே கர்த்தருக்கு ஏகபலியாக இருக்கிறது. ஆகவே இந்த சூழ்நிலையில் நாம் அனைவரும் எந்த விதமான வேதனையில இருந்தாலும் நம்மளால என்ன முடியுமோ, வாட் எவர் யூ கேன்,
இஃப் யூ நாட் ஈவன் ஏபிள் டு ஓபன் யுவர் மவுத் அண்ட் சிங், யூ கேன் ஜஸ்ட் லிப்ட் அப் யுவர் ஹார்ட்ஸ் டு காட் அண்ட் ஜஸ்ட் ஃபோக்கஸ் யுவர் தாட்ஸ் ஆன் ஹிம். Even as we sing this particular song, Jayam Kodukum Devanukku Kodi Kodi Stotram. Our God is a God of victory. He goes before us. Thanks be to God who gives us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. Through Jesus as we give the sacrifice of praise. Lord, and as we pray and sing these songs of healing, and as we go into the time of worship and as we sing the songs of healing as a family, I believe that the Spirit of God will enter into your homes and will touch each and every one of you and will restore everybody. So, ellarum urchagamaga, yaralla mudiyumo, mudiyadavargal, just be in the presence of God and lift your hearts to God. Jayam kodukum devanukku kodi kodi stotram.
Jayam kodukum, jayam kodukum, devanukku kodi kodi stotram. Yesu rajavukku vallalellam stotram. Jayam kodukum, devanukku kodi kodi stotram. Yesu rajavukku
அற்புதம் செய்பவர்,
Not during moments like this, the Lord is drawing closer to us, and we need to draw closer to Him. So can you make this a prayer today? Draw me close to you, Lord. Help me, Lord, to feel that you are near me. I lay it all down again. Whatever are your doubts, whatever are your fears, lay it all down before Him, because He is your friend. Make this a true prayer.
Draw me close to you. Never let me go. I lay it all down again to hear you say that I'm you are my desire. No one else will do. Cause nothing else could take your place. To feel the warmth of your find a way, bring me back to you. You're all I want. You're all I want. You're all I ever need to be. You're all I know. Help me, all you want me. Draw me close to you. Never let me go. I lay it all down. Yeah, put down everything, lay it all down. You say that I'm you are my desire. No one else will do. Cause nothing else could take your place. To feel the warmth of your face. Help me find a way. Bring me back to you.
Hide me now under your wings. Cover me, Lord, within your mighty hand.
I will soar with you, my God.
I rest my soul. In Christ alone, Christ alone. No, it's power.
No, it's power. I will surrender.
He said, King over this pandemic.
You are King of the Lord of Love. I will be still
for you. Yet they said,
that he led thee.
You will tell him, you are the Lord that killeth me. You are the Lord that killeth me. Tell him that you are the Lord. The Lord that killeth me. You are
God. It's not what's happening in your body. He is totally in control. It's not what the doctors can do. It's not what the medicines can do. Right now, you and I are challenged to put our trust totally in Him, because He is our healer. He needs to send forth His word and heal every broken body today. So let's say, in Thee, O Lord, do I put my trust.
In Thee, O Lord, do I put my trust.
This to Him, you are the Lord that healeth thee.
You are the God that healeth me. You are the God, my healer.
You sent your word, Jesus.
You sent your word and you healed my disease.
You are the Lord, my healer.
you
Just lift our hearts and say hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
God, we praise you.
God, we praise you. God, we praise you. God, we praise you. God, we praise you.
God, we thank you.
God, we thank you. Lord, we thank you. Lord, we thank you.
Yes, Father, this is our prayer. We thank you for your healing presence. We thank you because you have touched us. Thank you because you have made us aware of your presence. I firmly believe, oh God, that you have broken through into the hearts and homes of your dear children. Into the rooms of your dear children, and you're reviving their bodies, restoring them, healing them physically, spiritually, emotionally, and mentally. For this, we thank you and glorify you. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. I want to thank each and every one of you for joining this service today. I'm going to just pray for those who are celebrating their birthdays. Charlotte Sangeeta, Kavita Nirmal, Enoch Anand, Armin Chand, Albert Samuel John, and wedding anniversaries. Nirmal and Kavita Nirmal. Father, we thank you, O God, for the gift of life. We pray, Lord, that you will take care of each and every one of your children and bless them. May they see the riches of Christ that is provided for them on Calvary. May their spiritual eyes be opened to see the greatness of their Savior. Lord, bind them in their families with love. Reveal your plans and your purposes to them. Lord, for those who are celebrating their wedding anniversaries, continue to strengthen their marriage. Lord, their relationship with one another, let them continue to be a blessing to their family, to their children, to the church and to the community at large. We pray your blessing on each and every one of them. Even as we continue in prayer, Lord, we pray for people who are hurting all over the world even now. We want to think of missionaries back home in India. Lord, we pray that you will prosper their work, that the Holy Spirit of God will do miracles and wonders even through them. Father, we pray for our extended family members back home in India who are needing your touch. Touch them, oh God. Heal them. Restore them. People who are, Lord, in different circumstances, maybe not physical, but spiritually they are shaken. Lord, mentally, emotionally, they need healing, oh God. I pray for divine healing upon them. For your presence and your word to cover them. Hide them, oh God. Under your wings, cover them within your mighty hand. Help them to find rest. Rest for their souls in Christ alone, in quietness and trust. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
want to make the announcements today. I think we are moving ahead. We want to thank everyone who has joined us today and everyone who's helping to take care of those who need help. We want to thank you, and you'll be continued. You'll be receiving more information if more help is needed during this week as to how we can, as a family, with love for one another. This is what it means to be disciples of Christ. Loving one another, supporting one another, not only in prayer, but even physical needs being provided for. So if you need any help whatsoever in whatever situation you're in, feel free to call me personally or any one of the leaders in the church council you want to convey to them. But please do inform us. Brother Ben has put out that sheet in that men's fellowship group where we've been providing help during this past week. If you want to continue, please put your names up there and we'll continue to help you and do all that is necessary, because this is what it means to be Christ followers, helping one another, supporting one another at this most critical time. As the church family, we want to say that and believe that particular verse that Paul wrote in Corinthians when he described how a church functions. He said, if one part of the body hurts, the entire body hurts. I want to tell you, I hurt. It hurts. It hurts. The entire body hurts. We hurt with everyone who is hurting out there, physically, spiritually, emotionally, mentally, whatever situation you are in, we hurt with you, because we are part of that one body of Christ. And we pray and believe that God is doing a miracle. He is a miracle worker. He is near us and he is restoring everything as he is divinely disrupted through his intervention. He is going to reveal his divine purpose even as we are walking through this path. Thank you for joining, and we'll continue to have our service next week online on April 18th. I would like to tell everybody that the service will be fully online, and for offertory, you can go to tamilgospelchurch.org or you can contact Brother Frank Abraham. And the Lenten offering, 100% of the proceeds will go for missionary support. So if you have not yet turned in your Lenten offerings, please make sure that you do that. And we'll be having our regular Wednesday prayer at 8:30 p.m. to 9:30 p.m. this coming Wednesday. And we'll be focused and praying for the current needs. And with regard to the men's fellowship meeting, you would receive notice. It's scheduled for April 24th, but whether it's going to happen or not, we will keep you posted. That's all I have for the announcement. Now we'll have the offertory song. Let us thank God for the offering. Father, we want to thank you, Lord, for enabling us to even give to your kingdom and to work for the kingdom of God, to the work that you are doing on this earth. நீர் எங்களுக்கு கொடுத்த ஆசீர்வாதங்களுக்காக நன்றி. நாங்கள் எங்களையும் உம்முக்காக உம்மிடம் நாங்கள் படைக்கிறோம் ஆண்டவரே. நீர் எங்களை எடுத்து உபயோகியும், நாங்கள் கொடுத்த காணிக்கை எடுத்து உபயோகியும். இயேசுவின் நாமத்தினாலே ஆமென்.
Today's Bible reading is taken from Matthew chapter 14, verses 22 to 33. Immediately, Jesus made the disciples get into the boat and go on ahead of him to the other side. While a dismissed crowd, after he had dismissed them, he went up on a mountainside by himself to pray. Later that night, he was there alone, and the boat was already a considerable distance from the land, buffeted by the waves because the wind was against it. Shortly after dawn, Jesus went out to them walking on the lake. When the disciples saw him walking on the lake, they were terrified. "It's a ghost," they said, and cried out in fear. But Jesus immediately said to them, "Take courage, it is I, do not be afraid." "Lord, it is you," Peter replied. "Tell me to come to you on the water." "Come," he said. Then Peter got down out of the boat, walked on the water, and came toward Jesus. But when he saw the wind, he was afraid, and beginning to sink, cried out, "Lord, save me." Immediately Jesus reached out his hand and caught him. "You of little faith," he said, "why did you doubt?" And when he climbed into the boat, the wind died down. Then those who were in the boat worshiped him, saying, "Truly you are the Son of God." The word of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God.
Heavy poem. Lord, I pray that you will speak. Your word brings healing because your word is spirit and life. Let your teaching fall like rain, your words descend like dew, like showers on new grass and abundant rain on tender plants. Let it revive our sagging spirits, O God. Revive us, O Lord. I know revival begins with the word of God. Even as we come back to the basics of your word and what you teach us, make it so clear. May we hear the voice of the Holy Spirit, incline our hearts to be obedient to you and to receive your word with humility. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. The illusion of control. The illusion of control. மாயை, இல்யூஷன் என்று அந்த வார்த்தை சொல்லும் மாயை, கட்டுப்பாடு. நாம் சில காரியங்களை கட்டுப்பாட்டோடு காரியங்களை நாம் செய்கிறோம். நம்முடைய வாழ்க்கை கட்டுப்பாட்டோடு இருக்கிறோம். நம்மளுடைய கட்டுப்பாட்டு, நம்மளுடைய கட்டுகளில இருக்க வேண்டும் என்று நாம் நினைக்கிறோம். ஆனால் அது ஒரு மாயை. The control that we think that we have over our lives is an illusion. Why do I say that? Because it's my experience. And I believe it is also your experience. And that is why I clearly now understand why James said, If somebody tells you, let us go to this city or that town and say, let's do business there, let's maybe do this particular thing there, the answer you should have is, if it is the Lord's will, we will do it. கர்த்தருடைய சித்தமானால் நாம் அந்த காரியத்தை செய்வோம். இன்னும் வாழ்க்கையில அதிகமாக வாழும் பொழுது நம்மளுக்கு கிடைக்கிற அனுபவத்தின் மூலம் என்ன நடைபெறுகிறது என்றால், இந்த கட்டுகள் இருக்கிறோம். இந்த கட்டுகள் என்றால் இந்த கட்டுப்பாடு, கண்ட்ரோல் என்ற வார்த்தை, கண்ட்ரோல். நாம் கண்ட்ரோல் பண்ணுகிறோம், நமக்கு நம்மளுடைய கட்டுப்பாடோடு இருக்கிறது என்று நாம் நினைக்கிற காரியங்கள், அது ஒரு மாயை. ஏனென்றால் நமக்கு எந்த கட்டுப்பாடும் இல்லை. We think we have, but the ultimate control is not in our hands. There is one who controls. இன்றைக்கு the illusion of control என்ற காரியத்தை குறித்து பேசும் பொழுது, நாம் வாசித்த இந்த வேத பாகத்திலிருந்து சில காரியங்களை நாம் கற்றுக்கொள்ளும்படியாக நான் இந்த பாகத்தை இன்றைக்கு தெரிந்து கொண்டேன். மத்தேயு எழுதுகிறார் 14 அதிகாரத்திலே 22 வசனத்திலிருந்து 33 வசனம் வரை. என்ன நடக்கிறது என்றால், மார்க்கும் யோவானும் 6 அதிகாரத்திலே இதே காரியத்தை சொல்லுகிறார்கள். இது என்ன காரியம்? இந்த கதை நம்ம எல்லாருக்கும் தெரியும். நம்ம எல்லாரும் ஒரு கேள்வி கேட்டோம்னா, யாரு ஒரு கடல்ல நடந்தா, ஒரு மிரக்கிள், a walking on water, defying gravity. கிராவிட்டி வந்து, அதாவது நம்ம வந்து கிராவிட்டினா மேல போற காரியம் கீழே வரணும். ஒரு கடல் அலையில நடுவுல நடுமத்தில யாருமே நடக்க முடியாது. You will go down. So defying gravity, defying whatever are the natural forces there, there is a person who walked on the water. And அந்த ஒரு காரியம், அந்த கதையில இருந்து நாம் சில காரியங்களை நாம் கற்றுக்கொள்ள போகிறோம். நம்ம எல்லாருக்கும் தெரியும். We all know this story. It's quite a familiar story. But we want to revisit this story today to help us understand in our situation. என்னவென்றால், மார்க் யோவான் இந்த இன்னும் ஒரு இம்பார்ட்டன்ட் டீடைல வந்து எழுதல. தே ரைட் ஒன்லி அபவுட் டில் ஜீசஸ் வாக்ட் ஆன் வாட்டர். நம்ம எல்லாருக்கும் தெரியும், இயேசு கிறிஸ்து கடலை நடந்து வந்தார். ஆனால் மத்தேயு மட்டும்தான், the man, the second man who walked on water, who was Peter, அதை குறித்த அந்த ஒரு காரியத்தை எழுதுகிறார். When does this event happen? இந்த இவெண்ட் எப்போது நடைபெறுகிறது என்றால், நம்ம எல்லாருக்கும் தெரியும், 5000 பேருக்கு என்ன பண்ணாங்க, இயேசு கிறிஸ்து 5000 பேருக்கு போஷித்தார். நாட் ஆக்சுவலி வசனத்தை போகும்போது 5000 மனிதர்கள் தான் இருந்தார்கள், men, but besides women and children. So approximately 15,000 people were fed on that day. அந்த மிரக்கல் முடிந்த பிறகு, மிரக்கல் நடந்து முடிஞ்சிச்சு, எல்லாரும் they all gathered up the broken pieces left over, number of those who ate was 5,000 men besides women and children. முடிச்ச உடனே மத்தேயு எழுதுகிறார் 22 வசனத்தை வாசிக்கும்படியால் தமிழ வாசிக்கும்படியாக கேட்கிறேன்.
இயேசு ஜனங்களை அனுப்பிவிடுகையில் தம்முடைய சீஷர்கள் படவில் ஏறி தமக்கு முன்னே அக்கறைக்கு போகும்படி அவர்களை துரிதப்படுத்தினார்.
Immediately Jesus made the disciples get into the boat and go on ahead of him to the other side while he dismissed the crowd. நினைச்சு பாருங்க, 15,000 பேர் இருக்கிறாங்க, 12 சீஷர்களுக்கு எல்லாருக்கும் சாப்பாடு கொடுத்தாங்க. என்ன பண்ணணும்? இயேசு கிறிஸ்து தான் ஃபர்ஸ்ட் போகணும். டயர்டா இருக்கிறேன், 3 பிரசங்கம் பண்ணிட்டாரு, அவர் போகணும். பட் அவர் என்ன சொல்றாருன்னா, டிசைபிள்ஸ் ரிசர்வ் பண்ணவங்க 12 பேர், நீங்க போங்க, நான் இந்த மக்களை வந்து நான் அனுப்பி விடுறேன். அண்ட் he immediately disciples got into the boat on Jesus's instruction. So did the disciples say, Jesus, engalukku romba tired ah irukku, 3 naal ellam prasangam panninga, ellarku saapadu kuduthaachu, we are very tired, so we need to go or boat ride la polam? illa appadi la avan kekkave illa. Yesu Christ avangala vandu neenga boat la yeri neenga ponga nu solli avangala anuppi uttaar.
Jesus is in control. Jesus is in control. He instructs the disciples to go to the other side. Boatla poranga. Quickly, let's see what happens. After he had dismissed them, 23rd vasanatha vasikka solluva vasikka mudiya kekkuren.
அவர் ஜனங்களை அனுப்பிவிட்ட பின்பு தனித்து ஜபம் பண்ண ஒரு மலையின் மேல் ஏறி சாயங்காலம் ஆன போது அங்கே தனிமையாயிருந்தார்.
Probably early afternoon, lunch எல்லாம் முடிச்ச பிறகு எல்லாரும் அனுப்பி விட்டாச்சு, போட்ல வந்து அனுப்பி விட்டாச்சு டிசைபிள்ஸ். He went by himself on a mountain side to pray. You know, after a high, it's always very important to become very calm and quiet all by yourself to pray. And to be in the presence of God. And he was constantly in touch with God, his father. He knew what God was doing. He wanted to know. In the miracle, he knows what's happening. And he is in the presence of God, receiving instructions. And what happens is when evening came, the boat was already a considerable distance from land, buffeted by the waves because the wind was against it. இந்த கலிலேயா இந்த கடல்ல வந்து இந்த இருக்க கடல் அது உள்ள போன உடனே கொஞ்சம் டிஸ்டன்ஸ் உள்ள போன உடனே இட் பிகம்ஸ் வெரி வெரி என்ன சொல்றது ரஃப் த வேவ்ஸ் பிகம் ரஃப் கடல் அலைகள் மிகுந்த ரஃபா இருக்கு நடுமத்தில போயாச்சு இந்த டிசைபிள்ஸ் ஹூ ஆர் தீஸ் டிசைபிள்ஸ் இயேசு கிறிஸ்துவோட சீஷர்கள் யாரு இயேசு கிறிஸ்துவோட சீஷர்கள் வந்து அங்க இருக்கிறவங்கல வந்து தே ஆர் ப்ரொஃபஷனல்ஸ் They know how to row a boat. They know how to fish. So they're very comfortable with what's happening, what they've been told. But now they are in the middle of the sea, rough winds. Usually they say Sea of Galilee. Suddenly there are squalls that will come. They call it the furious storm suddenly. Innoru storm pathi Matthew 8th adhigarathila Matthew records about that storm that happens. It's not the same incident, it's a different incident. So in the madriyana or a storm mari nadakkudu, buffeted by the waves, the waves are so strong. Ungalude vaalkaiyila sila kaaryangal alai pola vandikitte iruka, or adi mele or adi vilundikitte iruka. Things are happening. Already certain things are down. And now on top of that, something else is happening. And then on top of that, something else is happening. And on top of that, something else is happening. Alaigal mele alaigal. And it comes to a point where you are beginning to sense that you are losing control. You're buffeted by the waves. Enna nadakkudhunu ungalukku theriyala. Yen idu nadandhadhunu theriyala. There are mental waves that are hitting you, saying, Andavare, nee ippadi sonneer, ana ippadi nadakkudhu. Vasanam ippadi solugudhu. ஏன் இந்த மாதிரியாக நடக்குது ஆர் யூ பீங் பஃபட்டட் பை த வேவ்ஸ் இன் யுவர் மைண்ட் எமோஷனலி ஆர் யூ கோயிங் த்ரூ திங்ஸ் பிகாஸ் ஆல்ரெடி சர்டன் திங்ஸ் ஆர் ஹேப்பனிங் ஹியர் தென் எமோஷனலி சம் அதர் திங்ஸ் ஆர் ஹேப்பனிங் அவுட் தேர் விச் இஸ் அஃபெக்டிங் யூ பிசிக்கலி யூ நோ வி ஆர் காம்போசிட் பீயிங்ஸ் வி ஆர் ஹோல் பீயிங்ஸ் வாட் ஹேப்பன்ஸ் அஃபெக்ட்ஸ் அஸ் பிசிக்கலி அண்ட் ஈவன் நவ் வாட்ஸ் ஹேப்பனிங் அரவுண்ட் அஸ் Not only right here in America, but throughout the world. The news that we are getting is so scary. It seems it's like not the first wave we spoke about last year. Second wave, today somebody was saying we've lost count of the number of waves. Third wave, fourth wave. And somebody told me, a research expert told me, probably there are 6 or 7 variants already. Variants, we know. Out there of COVID-19. And Johnson & Johnson vaccine, I'm not making a commercial for them, but they've covered 4 variants, unlike the other 2 vaccines. They've covered at least 4 variants. They say B1, B2, Enamola number Kulkranga. I'm not making a commercial, but just to tell you, they only covered 4, but by the time I was 7. They're saying third wave, fourth wave. Nama first wave, ippadhaan kadandhu vandhom. Second wave, edho kadandhu tappichu vandhom. Patta third wave. It's hitting us. It's hitting home. And then they think there's going to be more waves out there. What are we going to do? It seems like we are losing control. As if we were
at one point in time in control of what was happening to us. You know, this is a time that the creator of this universe, God, the one who rules the nature, the one who rules everything and is perfect control, the sovereignty of God that we talk about, the doctrine of sovereignty, sometimes we do not understand it fully. Sovereign, it's so easy to say, what is the doctrine of sovereignty? கர்த்தர்னாலே எல்லா காரியம் செய்ய முடியும் அவ்வளவு ஈஸியா நம்ம வசனம் சொல்றோம் Omnipotent God, omniscient God, omnipresent God. Can we believe that at this moment? Yes, he is all powerful. Yes, he is all knowing. Yes, he is present right now in our midst. The doctrine of sovereignty is such a scary doctrine. He is still in control. Can we believe that when things are totally out of control? That is why I said, I titled this message as an illusion of control. கட்டுப்பாடை வைத்துட்டா மாயை அது ஒரு மாயை நம்மளுக்கு எப்ப என்ன நடக்கும் என்று தெரியாது. Every day the fact that we even wake up with our breath, wake up with our health, we do not know what happens overnight or within a few hours. Things can change just in a moment. Is God just trying to use this particular time of this global pandemic to teach us as his children that, listen, even in the first place, you never had any control. You thought you had. You thought you had. It was an illusion. I am in total control. He sent, immediately he sent them. And now the disciples are buffeted by the waves on the boat. They are professionals. Even now we think. I want to tell you about a call that I got from the county office. It's not to scare anybody. I know we are all going through very difficult times. And the county office, as many of you have received calls, the county office also called us at home because you know our situation too. To find out who is the one who is affected and what we are supposed to do. And then he was telling the number of cases that they are receiving is so high at this time. So high. And two things he said. People who got COVID last year are returning back. Well, getting it back again. People who are vaccinated are also getting it back again. So what is going on? The officer said, is it the first case? He asked us whether we have done certain things. And then he said, this is what is happening. This is what I see from a government official. People are outside trying to get control. Humanity is trying to get control. மனுஷீகம் வந்து நம்ம கண்ட்ரோல் பண்றதுக்கு இதை செய்யலாம் அது செய்யலாம்னு சொல்லி கண்ட்ரோல் பண்ண பாக்குறாங்க. பட் வேவ் ஆஃப்டர் வேவ் இஸ் ஹிட்டிங் லைக் ஹவ் த டிசைபிள்ஸ் ஆர் பீங் பஃபட்டட் பை த வேவ்ஸ். த டிசைபிள்ஸ் வென்ட் த்ரூ நாட் த ஃபர்ஸ்ட் டைம், திஸ் இஸ் தி செகண்ட் டைம் ப்ராபபிலி. சோ தே ஆல்ரெடி ஹேவ் அன் எக்ஸ்பீரியன்ஸ். த ஃபர்ஸ்ட் டைம் வென் இட் ஹேப்பன்ட், ஜீசஸ் வாஸ் இன் த போட் வித் தெம் அண்ட் ஹி வாஸ் ஸ்லீப்பிங். அது எவ்வளவு ஒரு கம்ஃபர்ட் இருக்கும், இயேசு கிறிஸ்து இருக்கிற நம்மளோட அது போதும். அப்ப கூட பயந்தாங்க, போய் எழுப்புனாங்க. டோன்ட் யூ கேர் லார்ட் தட் வி ஆர் ட்ரவுனிங், தட் வி ஆர் கோயிங் டு பி ட்ரவுனிங் சோன். பட் நவ் ஜீசஸ் இஸ் நாட் ஈவன் இன் தி போட், ஜீசஸ் இஸ் நாட் ஈவன் வித் அஸ் ஹவ் மெனி ஆஃப் அஸ் திங். ஆண்டவரே, நீ என்னை கைவிட்டுட்டீரா? நீ என்ன சொன்னீரா? உன்னுடைய வார்த்தையை நீ செய்யவில்லையா? டிட் யூ லெட் மீ கோ? நோ. As we sang some drumming, never let me go. He will never let us go. We sang that song, never let me go. Because you know why? Why we sang it? The way the songwriter has written that chorus, that song is so interesting. Draw me close to you, never let me go. Because we are the ones who will pull away from him. Namana avara vittu poiruvom, dura poiruvom. அவர் நம்முடைய ஒரு போதும் நம்ம விட்டு போக மாட்டார். என்றால் ஹி இஸ் குட் ஃபார் ஹிஸ் வேர்ட். ஹிஸ் ப்ராமிசஸ் யூ கேன் ட்ரஸ்ட் இட் மோர் தென் ட்ரஸ்டிங் எனி ஹியூமன் பீயிங் ஆன் திஸ் எர்த். including your very own spouse or your children. You can trust God. It is better to trust in God than to trust in princes, than to trust in the medical technology, than to trust in a man who can give us some solution. We thought that men can give solution to us. In fact, it was Charles Stanley who said, it is God who heals and the doctors get paid. It is God who heals and it's the doctors who get paid. They get a lot of money. Ultimate healing comes from our Father in heaven. People who do not know this living God will not realize it. But you and I as followers of Christ will have to realize, from where does the healing flow? When you're buffeted by the waves of this world, by the trials of this world, by the difficulties of this world, trying to maintain control, saying, if I do this, do that. We can maintain. No. Illusion. I am not saying that you should not do those things. It doesn't mean that. You're under your control. So do what you want. No, it's not like that. We are in a relationship with him. We work with him. And when we work with him, we receive instructions from him and do what he says. So what's happening here is, mudhalavadhu naan sonna, Jesus is in control because he sends the disciples out and they are being buffeted by the waves. So do not think that you went away or you went by yourself. Jesus has allowed this situation to happen and he is fully aware. You did not do anything to earn it. I did not do anything to earn it, or whatever is happening in our lives. God has allowed it with a purpose. Now people are buffeted because Jesus sent them. He knew that a storm was going to come. They're going to be buffeted by the waves. He was in prayer. And here the disciples are. They're perfect. They can keep rowing. They can go on to the other side. Now they are beginning to lose control and they are being buffeted. They are being shaken in their faith because the wind was against it. So the winds that blow against your life and my life, it could be a physical sickness. It could be a spiritual sickness. It could be a mental sickness. It could be an emotional sickness. It could be a strained relationship right now. You are strained in your relationship with somebody and it is hurting your body. Maybe we need to set that right. Because as I said, we are composite beings. It's all interconnected. You know, when certain things take place, yellow parents on the sila children of the silakari and narakala nala, silakariangal, tappa narandirchina. You know how much the parents get affected and they lose their health? What happened? My father was so perfectly well and in the kari narandona or health poetry. Why? Interconnected. Because his heart was weighed down. He was distressed. That affected the body. And what happened? He became sick. Whatever kinds of sicknesses, enna kaarigal vandhalum, you're waiting for something and then suddenly this is hitting you, uncertainty, whatever it is. We think that we are in control, but we are not. We need to do our part, which is very limited, and leave the rest. During the fourth watch of the night, precise timing, Matthew Eldrade. நான்காவது ஜாமத்தில் 25வது வசனத்தை வாசிங்க.
இரவின் நான்காம் ஜாமத்திலே இயேசு கடலின் மேல் நடந்து அவர்களிடத்திற்கு வந்தார். அவர் கடலின் மேல் நடக்கிறதை சீஷர்கள் கண்டு கலக்கம் அடைந்து ஆவேசம் என்று சொல்லி பயத்தினால் அலறினார்கள். உடனே இயேசு அவர்களோட பேசி, திடன் கொள்ளுங்கள், நான் தான், பயப்படாதிருங்கள் என்றார். பேதுரு அவரை நோக்கி, ஆண்டவரே, நீரேயானால் நான் ஜலத்தின் மேல் நடந்து உம்மிடத்தில் வர கட்டளையிடும் என்றான்.
நான்காம் ஜாமம் 3 மணியில் இருந்து காலையில 6 மணி வரைக்கும். And there is a saying, that goes like this. It is darkest before the dawn. And somebody told me that when things were very, very difficult for me, one pastor told me, and it is still in my memory, when everything was looking so dark, he said, it is darkest before the dawn. There is a gleam of light that is awaiting you. Does it seem very dark to you right now in your situation? There is light. The light of God's healing is coming upon each and every one of you. Is it dark, very dark? Some of us have come through it. Some of us are still there. It seems dark, but remember, there is light. It is darkest before the dawn. Light is awaiting you. It's right there. And what happened? 3 mani, 6 mani varaikum nadandhu varugirar. Disciples saw him walking on the lake. They were terrified. When Jesus walks and comes, you become terrified. They're thinking, "Ave some ghost," and they cried out in fear, thinking it was a ghost, totally losing control, as if thinking they were even in control. They're not even in control, but when things are happening, suddenly you begin to feel things are totally going out of control. They're crying out in fear. But you know what? At this time, Jesus is in control of what's happening. He's walking on the lake. He's walking on that lake, it is said. Go to the other side. And in this lake, it said he was walking on the lake. They were terrified. They cried out in fear. And Jesus immediately said to them, "Take courage. It is I. Don't be afraid." You know, when it is very, very dark, who's with you? Jesus is with you. Jesus is with you. And when you're afraid, binding in and out to that, by blood in that, it is I. It reflects on Exodus. When Moses saw the burning bush and asked a question, "Who should I say is sending me? I am." It is I. You know the rendition of it? It is I am. Don't be afraid. Yahweh, who was there, is now in human form, in the flesh. Jesus, as the Son of God, is walking on this earth. And he is saying, "Take courage. It is I. Don't be afraid." Jesus is in control. The illusion of control that we had was broken for the disciples when all these waves were happening. And Jesus saying, "I'm in control. Do not be afraid." "Lord, if it's you," Peter replied, "tell me to come to you on the water." And Jesus said, "Come." நம்மளை எவ்வளவு ஆண்டவரையும் வல்லமை காண வேண்டும், ஆண்டவரே உங்களுடைய இன்டர்வென்ஷன் வேணும் உங்களுடைய வாழ்க்கையில, ஆண்டவரே நாங்கள் உண்மை இன்னும் அதிகமாக அறிய வேண்டும் என்று சொன்னா, அவர் வந்து the way that he teaches and reveals who he is not the way we think that we need to be taught. He will reveal himself in only risky situations. If everything is calm and smooth, yes, it's easy to praise God. That is why it is called a sacrifice of praise and returning. When something is broken inside of you, when you're able to praise God at that moment, it's a sacrifice of praise. But right here you see, Jesus said, "Come," in the Chonar, because he wants to reveal to Peter who he is. Pedro kandu naan yaar endru velippadutha padradhukaga. So udane Pedro enna pandrana, elundichu nadandhu. He becomes the second man to walk on the lake, walked on the water, came toward Jesus. "Draw me close to you, Lord." He came toward Jesus. But when he saw the wind, he was afraid and beginning to sink, cried out, "Lord, save me. Hosanna." Indha oru kaariyathai aneka tharam eppadi people vandu interpret pannuvaanga na, andha kadal alaiya paatha odana avan vandu இது பண்ண அவன் வந்து அந்த இதுல போக உள்ள போறதுக்கு அவன் இதாயிருச்சு. அந்த வசனத்தை வாசிக்க 30வது வசனம்.
காற்று பலமாய் இருக்கிறதை கண்டு பயந்து அமிழ்ந்து போகையில் ஆண்டவரே என்னை ரட்சியும் என்று கூப்பிட்டான்.
அமிழ்ந்து போகையில் காற்றை கண்டு பயந்து. சோ என்ன சொல்லுவாங்கன்னா, இந்த மாதிரி காற்றை பார்க்கும் பொழுது அவன் காற்றை பார்த்தான், அதனாலதான் வந்து அவனுக்கு வந்து இங்க வந்து அவன் இதாயிட்டான். அந்த மற்ற சர்க்கம்ஸ்டன்சஸ் எல்லாம் பார்த்தான், எஸ் அதெல்லாம் பார்த்தோன்னா பயந்தான். ப்ராப்ளி ஹி வாஸ் அவேர், ஹி இஸ் அ ஃபிஷர்மேன். ஹிஸ் மீடியா அட் த டைம் இன்ஃபார்ம்ட் ஹிம் தட் இந்த மாதிரி வேவ்ஸ் எல்லாம் இருந்தா யூ வில் கோ டவுன், யூ ஆர் பிரைம் கேண்டிடேட், பிரைம் யூ வில் கோ டவுன், தேர்ஸ் நோ எஸ்கேப் ஃபார் யூ என்றுதான் அவனோட மீடியா இன்ஃபர்மேஷன். So probably he looked at that media. The switch that we need to make right here is, it is not looking at that. It is the shift in your mindset, divine mindset. Remember, we learned about this divine mindset, thinking differently. Jesus was transforming Peter's mind. It was not that he was looking at that. He always knew you could walk on water. Yes, you trusted in me. I am telling you, come, you can walk on water. So he was walking on water. But what happened? He looked at it because his media information corrupted his mind and he got scared. And he was beginning to sink. See, he never sank. Peter, many of us think that he sank. No, he never sank. He just began to sing, and immediately Jesus, the Son of God, his Savior, said, he cried out to him and said, Lord, save me, Hosanna, andavare enai rakshiyum, andar kaiya kudutar vandrupa mela kaiya pidichittukitte rendu perum poi boat la poi ukandutanga, and everything calmed down. They went, and andha time andavar vandu ore idhe padatha sonnar, you of little faith.
உடனே இயேசு கையை நீட்டி அவனை பிடித்து, அற்ப விசுவாசியே ஏன் சந்தேகப்பட்டாய் என்றார்.
அற்ப விசுவாசியே, அற்புதம் செய்பவர் உங்களோடு இருக்கும் போது நம்முடைய விசுவாசம் எவ்வளவு அற்புதமாக இருக்கணும், ஆனா அற்பமா இருக்கிறது. அற்ப விசுவாசியே, why did you have little faith, why did you doubt? அந்த previous stormலே வந்து ஓ யூ ஹவ் லிட்டில் ஃபெய்த், எல்லாரையும் சொன்னார். இப்போ வந்து இங்க பீட்டரை மட்டும்தான் சிங்கிள் அவுட் பண்ணி, ஒன் ஆன் ஒன் ஹி சேயிங், யூ ஹவ் லிட்டில் ஃபெய்த், வை டிட் யூ டவுட். See, he never told him, we think that, he never told him that, நீயே அங்க பார்த்த, நீ என்னையே பார்த்துட்டு இருக்கணுமே. நம்ம சில பேர் ஒரு பிள்ளைகளை கை வச்சு நடக்கும்போது, இல்லாட்டி சைக்கிளை ஓட்டும் போது, நம்ம எப்படி சொல்லி கொடுப்போம் பிள்ளைங்களுக்கு, நேரா பார்க்கணும், வேற எங்கேயும் பார்க்க கூடாது, நேரா பார்த்துட்டு அப்படியே ஓட்டணும், இல்லாட்டி நீ என்னைய பார்த்துக்கிட்டே ஓட்டிட்டு வா, எங்கேயும் பார்க்காத. ஆண்டவர் வந்து சொல்லியிருக்கணுமே, நீ ஏன் அங்க பார்த்த பீட்டர், ஏன் பேதர் நீ அதெல்லாம் பாக்குற, என்னையான பார்த்துட்டு வர சொன்ன. இல்ல, யூ ஆஃப் லிட்டில் ஃபெய்த், வை டிட் யூ டவுட், யூ நோ யூ ஆர் வாக்கிங் ஆன் வாட்டர், யூ ஆர் எ மிராக்குலஸ் கை ரைட் ஹியர் அட் திஸ் மோமெண்ட், யூ ஆர் டிஃபைங் கிராவிட்டி அண்ட் ஆல் த நேச்சுரல் ஃபோர்ஸஸ் தட் டெல் யூ தட் யூ கேனாட் வாக் ஆன் வாட்டர், யூ ஆர் வாக்கிங் ஆன் வாட்டர் because I was with you. You can't do it alone. I was with you. I am enabling you. That is how, after when we go through this phase, we will know that we walked on water with him. When things have been happening the way it has happened this past week in our lives, you know what? After some time, when we look back, we will know that we walked on water with Jesus. Otherwise, we will sink. People will sink in the situation. Many people sink. Here, though maybe some of us are beginning to sink, it's okay. It's okay. Jesus on the, he's not saying, no. You maybe you're doubting a little bit. You're beginning to question certain things. It's okay. Jesus would say, Arpa Viswati, come on. Why do you doubt? Come. He will give your hand. He will give his hand and he will pull you right back. So Peter, it was not about just looking at Jesus. He was participating in a miracle. And for him, it was a miracle. It's that you're defying every law. in the natural realm, and he was walking on water. And Jesus was telling him, you have little faith. You are doing it, man. Come on. Don't doubt. Why did you doubt? So, Ibiraya, therefore, looking around at the cloud of witnesses, the witnesses that have gone before us, how are we supposed to run our race? Looking unto Jesus, the author and finisher of our faith. You know what? The one who starts our faith and finishes our faith is Him. We don't start our faith. He is the one who starts our faith. We participate with Him to grow our faith. It doesn't happen automatically. And you know, right now, what is happening is creating a growth spurt in our TGC church family for us to believe in the miracle working power of God. Faith is growing in each and every one of our hearts that there is a God who is in control. So, why did he doubt? And when they climbed into the boat, the wind died down. Then those who were in the boat worshipped him, saying, truly you are the Son of God.
8th
அந்த புயல் அடித்து அந்த டிசைபிள்ஸ் எல்லாம் இதான உடனே ஆண்டவர் வந்து you of little faith, why are you so afraid ன்னு சொல்லிட்டு அவர் வந்து he got up, rebuked the winds and he said be still என்று சொன்னார். It was completely calm. அதுக்கப்புறம் the men, the disciples were amazed and asked, what kind of man is this? Even the winds and the waves obey him. What kind of a man in it? What kind of a man is this? The wind and the waves obey him. But now, second incident, what is happening? They worshipped him and just read that last verse. Think about that phrase that they, how did they worship him? They said, truly you are the Son of God. Meyagave ni Deva Kumaran. You know, in Matthew 16 only, Peter makes a personal confession, but here already the disciples together are making a confession. But now they look at a miracle and they are making a confession. Oh, yes, you did this miracle, so you are. At that time, there's no miracle. Nothing was happening. You say, okay, normal day. Who do you say that I am? Who do people say that I am? Peter had already realized, based on what God has done, and he said, you are Christ, the Son of the living God. You are Christ, the Messiah. Appadhaan, Yesu Christ sonnaar, flesh and blood has not revealed it to you, Peter, but my Father in heaven. Miracles are only signposts to reveal the Son of God. But many people live on miracles. But they are only signposts. Miracles will cease. Miracles will cease. But the Son of God will never cease to exist. Jesus was in control when he first sent the disciples out. Second observation, there was an illusion of control. Oru control kattupadu maayai nam ellarku irundichu avangalukku disciples ku irundichu. God broke that illusion of control and he told the disciples, proved it to the disciples that he is in control. He said, it is I. And in the encounter with Peter walking on water, Jesus said, you and I together are in control of what needs to happen. You need to partner with me. I am the one who's in control. You need to yield to me. If you continue to yield to me and trust in me, miracles will continue to take place. You will continue to walk on water. You will not sink. But if you allow the media or the messages that has been programmed in your mind to control you, you'll begin to sink. You'll have doubts. But you know, even then, Jesus does not give up on us. He says, Peter,
Arpa Viswasiye, why did you doubt? Give me your hand. Come. You and I together can make this happen. We can walk on water. Miracles will take place in your life and my life. I believe that is what God is doing. And may we yield ourselves into his mighty and marvelous hand. Amen. Mudivu paadalai paaduvom. Naan paavi thaan aanalum neer enna yetrukondir. Naan vandhen vandhen. இந்த பாடியை அர்ப்பணமாக பாடுவோம். I surrender each and every one of us into the hands of the Almighty God who is totally in control. Devadi Devanudaiya Anbu Kartharaga Yesu Kristuvin Kirubai Parisutha Aviyanarudaiya Aikyam Avarudaiya Sugam Alikkum Vallamaiyum Ungal Anaivarodum Indrum Indrum Sadakalam. May the love of God the Father, the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the fellowship of the Holy Spirit, and the power of God's healing presence abide with each and every one of you. Amen.
May the Lord bless you all. Thank you for joining.